Dear students, welcome you to BSc Physics second semester class. In today's session, we shall discuss about Maxwell's law of distribution of molecular velocity and its interpretation. Before going to the discussion, let us recall about the kinetic theory of gases. According to kinetic theory of matter, every substance consists of very large number of small particles called the molecules. Here on the screen, you can observe the three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gaseous state. The three states of matter consist of molecules, and these molecules are always in a continuous motion. In case of solids, intermolecular distances are small. Only motion is the vibration or oscillation motion in the solids. In case of liquids, molecules are free to move within the volume of the liquid. Since they are loosely bound, intermolecular distance is large compared to the solid molecules. In case of gas, intermolecular distances are very large compared to solid as well as liquid, and the molecules are free to move all over the space available. Now, let us concentrate about the kinetic theory of gases. The kinetic theory of gases describes gases as a large number of small particles or atoms or molecules, all of which are in constant and random motion. The rapidly moving particles constantly collide with each other and with the walls of the container. Kinetic theory explains macroscopic properties of gases such as pressure, temperature, viscosity, thermal conductivity, and volume by considering their molecular composition and motion. The theory postulates that gas pressure is due to the impact of molecules or atoms moving at different velocities on the walls of the container. Kinetic theory was put forward to explain the behavior of ideal gases and deviations of real gases from ideal behavior. The basis of this theory is that a gas consists of a large number of tiny discrete particles called molecules in rapid random motion. The kinetic theory of gas postulates is useful in understanding of the macroscopic properties from the microscopic properties. So now let us look into the postulates of kinetic theory. The following are the assumptions on which kinetic theory is based. Now, we can also look into the motion of the gas molecules and you can understand how the postulates of kinetic theory are applicable to the gaseous system or gaseous molecule. Gases are composed of a large number of particles called molecules. The molecules of the same gas are alike. Alike means same, but differ from the molecules of other gases. These particles are much smaller than the distance between the particles. So now you can observe the distance between the particles are large when compared to the size of the molecules. Most of the volume of a gas is therefore empty space. That means if you keep all the gas molecules together in that volume, in that vessel, it acquires a very small volume when compared to the available volume of the vessel. The molecules are in continuous motion with varying velocities. So that means the velocities of the particles are different for different particles. Each and every particle moves with a different velocity. So therefore the velocity is varying. So these particles move in a straight line until they collide with one another or with the walls of the container. After the collision, it will take another path or it will deviate to another straight line path. So the distance between any two consecutive collisions is called mean free path. Collisions between gas particles or collisions with the walls of the container are perfectly elastic. You know about the elastic collision. So in the case of elastic collision, the energy is conserved. So here none of the energy of a gas particle is lost when it collides with another particle or with the walls of the container. And there is no force of attraction between the gas particles or between the particles and the walls of the container. This is one of the basic assumptions of the ideal gases. Next postulate is the molecules are perfectly hard elastic spheres and the whole of their energy is kinetic energy. Now we shall look into the Maxwell's law of distribution of molecular velocity and its interpretation. On the basis of assumptions of kinetic theory of gases and by applying the laws of probability, James Clerk Maxwell in 1859 derived the law of distribution of speeds or velocities for the molecules of an ideal gas in a thermal equilibrium. The problem of knowing velocities of different molecules at different times was studied by Maxwell statistically and is called Maxwell's law. So here the important thing is, since the molecules are very large in number, so we give the number of molecules by the Avogadro number. For those large quantity of molecules, the velocities cannot be defined. If you want to calculate the velocity, we have to use a statistical method. Hence, Maxwell derived a law or an equation by using the statistical method. Maxwell suggested that the speed of molecules in a gas are distributed all over possible values. Most molecules have speeds not very far from the average speed. That means in a gas, different molecules have different velocities. So some have large velocity, some will move with a very small velocity. And in an average, most of all the molecules have some speed from one range to another range. So hence, at any time, all the molecules do not move with the same velocity. Some molecules will move with a velocity which is somewhat higher than the root mean square value. So while some may move with a velocity which is less than the root mean square value of the velocity. Maxwell's law of distribution of molecular velocities describes the steady state velocity distribution of molecules of a homogeneous monoatomic ideal gas under the conditions of thermodynamic equilibrium and the absence of an external force field. The Maxwell's distribution is a function f of v that gives the relative probability of a molecule having a particular speed v. This function is called the distribution function. If we observe total n molecules per unit volume, the number dn having speeds in the range between v and v plus dv, which is given by dn is equal to n into f of v dv. Next, probability that a randomly chosen molecule will have a speed in the interval v to v plus dv is f of v. This function f of v is a function of probability. Hence, f of v is the probability per unit speed interval, and that can be given by f of v is equal to dn by n, that is equal to 4 pi a to the power 3 into e to the power minus bc square into v square dv. At a particular temperature, the velocity of a gas molecule should vary between 0 and infinity, for which the probability is maximum. That means a gas molecule can have a velocity 0, that is the minimum velocity, and it can have any maximum velocity. The maximum velocity is nothing but the infinite velocity. So therefore, this is the range of velocities of any molecule, that is 0 and infinity is the range of velocity of any molecule. Hence, to have this speed dn, the number of molecules having velocity between v and v plus dv must be maximum, or the derivative of dn must be 0. Equation 2 seen earlier, that can be written as f of v is equal to dn, that is equal to 4 pi n into m by 2 pi kt to the power 3 by 2 into e to the power minus mv square by 2 kt into v square dv, which is equal to a constant. So here n is the number of molecules, m is the mass of the molecule, k is the Boltzmann constant, T is the temperature in Kelvin, v is the velocity of the molecule. So here the factor A is equal to square root of B by pi, that is equal to square root of m by 2 pi kT, and B is equal to m by 2 kT. The above equation is known as Maxwell's velocity or speed distribution law. So here in your syllabus there is no derivation of this equation. So only we can analyze the equation and interpret about the distribution of molecular velocity according to Maxwell. So here you can look into the figure shown here. So it is a molecular distribution of velocities of different molecules in a gas. It is a graph of number of molecules versus the speed of the molecules. Since all directions of motion of the molecules in space are equally probable, molecular velocity distribution is isotropic. This figure 1 shows the curve of the law of molecular velocity distribution. So here three characteristic speeds are marked. So what are those? The first one is the most probable velocity, which is given by Vp. Second one is average speed, V average. And the third one is root mean square speed, that is V RMS. What is the most probable velocity? The meaning of most probable velocity is nothing but a large number of molecules will have a velocity that is the probable velocity of the molecules. And if we take an average speeds of all the molecules, we get the average speed. And if we take the root mean square speed, so that will give the RMS speed. So these three speeds are shown in the graph. The root mean square speed, VRMS, which is equal to 483 meter per second, the most probable velocity, Vp, and the average speed of the oxygen molecules at the temperature 300 Kelvin are showing in the figure. A small number of molecules lying in the extreme right hand tail of the distribution curve can have speeds that are several times the average speeds. So now the condition for normalization of distribution function is integration from 0 to infinity f of v dv is equal to integration from 0 to infinity, that is the limits from 0 to infinity, 4 pi m by 2 pi kt to the power 3 by 2 into e to the power minus mv square by 2 kt into v square dv is equal to 1. You can observe the graph shown here. So it is drawn for number of particles or the molecule versus the speeds. So this graph shows the speeds of different molecules are different for different temperatures. So the temperatures are marked in the graph. You can observe as the temperature increases, the shape of the graph also is varying. Let us understand the shapes and what it interprets. So this graph is the distribution curve of molecular velocity, so that is F versus V plot. And for normalization, this is equal to unity. Maxwell proposed distribution for molecular velocities or speeds in a gas that is shown in the figure for three different temperatures, as I said earlier. For any gas at any temperature, given temperature, the tail of the each molecule, sorry, the tail of the graph is much longer on right than on the left. The portion which is longer on the right corresponds to high speeds of the molecules, and on the left it corresponds to low speeds. As the temperature increases, the peak of the graph curve shifts to the right. And the speed distribution becomes more broadly spread out. On increasing temperature, the most probable velocity increases and the length of the curve also increases. Height decreases and width increases. From the graph, we conclude that higher the temperature, higher are the speeds possessed by the gas molecules. However, the area under all these curves is same. If you calculate the area of these curves, the area will be equal, but the shape of the graph is different. Otto Stern and others found that molecular speeds are indeed distributed according to Maxwell's theory. This gave most direct proof of the kinetic molecular model of a gas. We shall continue in the next session.